Assalamu alaikum guys, our today's topic is solved example based on common emitter configuration. This will be the part 1 of common emitter configuration series, and in the previous one we will see the introduction and the formulas of common emitter configuration, but in this lecture we will see the circuits and find some parameters of CEC. So guys, let's start with the solution of example number 1. So guys, this will be our example number 1. And here you will see that this will common emitter configuration circuit, and there are two resistances present. This will be the base resistance RB, this will be the base voltage VBB, and this will be the collector resistance RC, and this will be the collector voltage VCC, and this branch is grounded between input loop and output loop, and this will be the emitter branch, so therefore it will be called the common emitter configuration. So guys, here beta of the transistor is given. The beta of the transistor is amplification factor. As we have already known that the beta of the transistor is amplification factor. Here beta of the transistor is given, and we will have to find the base current, the collector current, the emitter current, and collector emitter voltage, and similarly collector base voltage. So guys, first of all we analyze its input loop, and from the input loop you will see that there will be the battery present, and this voltage will be VBB voltage, and we will have to find IB from there. So if by Ohm's law IB, the base current IB will be equals to this voltage minus this voltage, because this will be the forward bias diode. As you have already known, this will be the forward bias diode, and this will be the junction present, and this junction is base emitter junction. So if it will be a forward bias diode, then the voltage drop is 0.7 volts. So therefore we will write VBB, this voltage minus this voltage, minus 0.7 volts divided by this resistance, and this resistance will be of 10k, and the answer will be 5 volts minus 0.7 volts divided by 10k, and this will be equals to 4.3 volts divided by 10k, and it will be equals to 0.43 milliampere. This will be the base current. Now we will have to find the collector current from there. As we have already known that the beta of the transistor, the amplification factor, will be equals to IC over IB. So you know beta from there, and you know IB, you will find IC from there. So now IC will be equals to beta times IB. IB will be multiplied over there. So beta will be equals to 150. So 150 multiplied by 0.43 milliamps. So it will be equals to 64.5 milliamps. So we will find IB, we will find IC. This will be the base current, this will be the collector current, collector current IC. So now we will have to find emitter current from there. As you have already know that IE will be equals to IC plus IB. The emitter current is the sum of both collector current and the base current. So now IE will be equals to 64.5 milliamps plus 0.43 milliamps. So it will be equals to 64.93 milliamps. So this will be the emitter current. So now we will have to find the collector emitter voltage. If you have to find collector voltage and then emitter voltage, then the difference between these voltages is called collector emitter voltage. So first you have to find VC from there. VC, the collector voltage. The collector voltage will be calculated from the output loop of the transistor. So From the output loop, you will see that this voltage will be dropped over this resistance minus this voltage drop, because there is a junction present, and this will be the junction is collector emitter junction, because this is emitter branch and this will be the collector branch. So here we will write VC will be equals to VCC minus IC into RC. VCC, this voltage drop will be minus from IC into RC, this voltage drop, then their voltage drop will be equals to VC. So VC will be equals to VCC, VCC will be equals to 10 volt. The collector battery is of 10 volts minus 64.5 milliamps. Sorry, 64.5, and RC will be of 100 ohms. So it will be equals to 3.57 volts. This will be equals to collector voltage. This will be the collector voltage. Collector voltage. So you will find VC from there, then VCE. The VCE will be equals to VC minus VE. As we have already noted that the emitter branch in this transistor is common, so there is no voltage drop over there, so VE will be equals to 0, VC minus 0. So VCE will be equals to VC, and VC will be equals to 3.57 volts. So this will be the collector emitter voltage. Collector emitter voltage. So now we will have to find another parameter, and this will be the collector base voltage. So first you have to find the base voltage, the VB. From there you can simply see that the base voltage in this side, you will see that the emitter voltage VE will be 0. VE will be equals to 0, and base voltage from this side to this side, base voltage will be equals to 0.7 volts, because it will be a forward bias diode, because this will be the NPN transistor. Negative is connected with the negative terminal of the battery, and positive is connected with the positive terminal of the battery, so it will be a forward bias diode. And due to the forward bias condition, this 0 volts plus 0.7 volts, this will be the base voltage formula. So VB will be equals to 0.7 volts from there. VB will be equals to 0.7 volts. So therefore VCB, the collector base voltage, will be equals to VC minus VB. So VC is equals to 3.57 volts minus 0.7 volts, and it will be equals to 2.87 volts. So guys, that's it for today. We will find all the parameters: the base current, the emitter current, the collector emitter voltage, and collector base voltage from there. So guys, that's all for today. If you like our video, then press on like button and subscribe our channel for more updates. Thank you.